Shalom. The only thing I can remember from my yeshiva days is Ma nishtana halayla sazeh mekola leila shebekola. It is my total privilege, Mr. President, to be here tonight to honor you as your family, friends, and the nation you helped create celebrate your 90th birthday. And it's my opportunity to share with all of you my admiration for this wonderful man who I've known for so many years. I admire Shimon Peres for who he is, a man who, with every meeting and every moment you are in his presence, embraces you not only physically, but emotionally, spiritually, and philosophically. But most of all, I admire him for his courage, for always being willing to challenge the status quo and to never accept that something is impossible. He is unafraid to sail against the wind and has always been willing to risk his all for what is right. At the request of the president, I'm going to sing a song that he loves. Maybe a different melody, Shimon, but it's the one I've loved for many years, Avinu Malkeinu, which I've never sung before live. It asks God to have compassion for us and our children, and to help bring an end to war and famine, and cause all hate and oppression to vanish from the earth. And we pray that can happen. Ah, thank you, thank you. That's so kind, thank you. Thank you. Shimon Peres gives me hope that Israel will meet its challenges because he knows that the key to a better tomorrow is the fact that, as President Clinton said, we are more alike than we are different, and that we share a common bond that links all. And when you really think about it, I mean, we're all just people. People who need people. Are the luckiest people in the world. We are. We're children needing other children, and yet letting a grown-up pride hide all the need inside, acting more like children than children. A very special people. They're the luckiest people in the world. With one person, one very special person, a feeling deep in your soul says you were half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst. First be a person who needs people. People who need people. The luckiest people in the world. True, don't they? A feeling deep in your soul says you are half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst. First be a person.